Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair guys. Today we're working on the Audi TT, but the video will relate to any vehicle guys that we're doing today. Spark plugs and flooded engine. Okay, if you for some reason flooded the engine, flooded spark plugs, it might not start. I'm gonna show you now. Okay, this one, what happened? We got them wet. We flooded it. And we're gonna show you guys how to clean spark plugs, what are the signs, the car might try to start and die. Okay, you're gonna... Okay, let me get the jump starter on because the battery is so weak from trying to start it. Okay, you see? It's trying, but it's not starting. And that's because most of the spark plugs are wet. Four cylinder engines, I think only one of them tries to start. So stay with us guys, we'll show you how to clean spark plugs, how to fix flooded engine and what to do next. Very important thing, how to deactivate the fuel pump so that way you don't flood it more. There we go, so what we're going to do, you can see this one, Audi, two of the spark plugs easy, but the other two, we have some vacuums here, so we'll need to disconnect this one here quick. Will differ. This is the 1.8 turbo, but the procedure will be basically very close for all vehicles. And still we'll remove this one, and there is a hidden one underneath it. Okay, so just a couple bolts with the Allen wrench. Okay, looks like this is, let me look at it, I think it's a 5 Allen wrench there. There is one more towards the back. Okay, perfect. So now we're going to disconnect the cables. This is very important. Let me show you guys how to do that quick. Okay, so you don't break them. You can see those are broken. People didn't know how to do it. It's important to grab this one, pull towards this way. Okay, to relieve the pressure and barely put any pressure on the clip now. Okay, and it's out. You can see. Now those will be more complicated and different ignition codes use different methods. But I need to reach it all the way like that. Because the tabs are broken. Okay, and this one too, all the way. Okay, so now, and if you wash the engine, that will be one of the procedures you need to do if you got your spark plugs wet. So now we're going to go ahead, pull ignition coils out. Okay, and I'm gonna pull all of them out and then I'll show you how we're gonna get water debris and stuff like that out so we don't get it in the cylinders. Okay, you can see wet. Okay, and now I'm gonna get the air compressor with the blower. Okay, and what we're going to do, we're going to blow inside to get everything out. So we're gonna get the spark plug tool now guys, and we're actually even using just a regular socket in our case, 5/8. We'll remove all four of them and let me show you a trick guys. If one of them actually, you cannot pick it with the socket or with the tool, I'm gonna show you how to pick them up. Stay with us, because sometimes those deep spark plugs are hard to get out. Okay, you can see you're supposed to have a rubber seal on the socket, but sometimes they don't hold the spark plugs. Check out guys the channel, many more videos to come. And also mechaniclifestyle.com is our website guys, and there we'll share more information, the tools we use, parts, links, where you can get them from. On Amazon, so that way you guys can save time and money. Okay, so we're gonna get the ignition coil in the spark plug. Okay, and just pull it out with the ignition coil. Look at that, this is a flooded spark plug now. Okay, let me see, because this one is really tight. Okay, let me get really, really good light on it now. This is really bad flooded spark plugs. So stay with us to see how we're going to fix that without buying new spark plugs. So we're gonna get a little torch now, guys. Those are very inexpensive. You can even buy smaller ones than that. Okay, and what we're going to do, actually we're going to heat them up really, really good. Never ever catch them after that with your hands until they're cool. Okay, and it's important to get inside of them. Look at that, that's gas right there burning. So we need to get them hot, really hot. That way everything will evaporate from there. And stay with us to see what else you need to do, guys, because we will need to make sure that you start it right, otherwise you might flood them again. How to deactivate the fuel pump for just a couple of seconds when starting the vehicle, really easy trick. Okay, you can see it's almost ready now. When they turn white like that, make sure they're dry, we turn them white. You see what else we're going to do to make sure that they will be working properly. So you guys, we're gonna let them cool now for probably 20-30 minutes, and we'll show you what we're going to do next. Let's see if that thing will start again. We have so much to do on it, but yep, we flooded it. So they're cool now, guys, we can touch them, preferably wear gloves. We're gonna get some fine sandpaper and just shine them a little bit where the contacting area, I mean where the spark plug is generated. So that way we can get really strong spark plug. We're going to do that to all four of them. Okay, you can see, to be clean. Okay, right there. And install them and see what happens next. We'll just go ahead and install them now, guys. Just same procedure, we took them apart. You can find the torque specs usually for your vehicle online if you need it to. And we'll give it a try and see if we can start it now. Okay, guys, so now what we're going to do, okay, let me demonstrate quick here. It's important not to start the car immediately. You're going to press the accelerator, the gas pedal, all the way to the floor. That way it's going to deactivate the fuel injectors, so it will prevent getting extra gas now. Okay, and after that we will let off of it and we'll start it. It fired right up. As you can see, it worked amazing, guys. That's how we fixed it. Please subscribe, let us know what you want to see on our channel. Also check out the website, guys, and see you next time.